Hey guys, welcome back. This is Tim from Tim's Electronics Lab. And today in this video, I'm going to show you how to convert the sketch that I'll use for my MQTT connections from the ESP 8266 SDK version 2.4.2 to version 2.5.0. And the main difference between the two is that the 2.4.2 uses a XTLS for its SSL and TLS encryption things, and version 2.5.0 uses bare SSL. So a few things need to be adjusted in order for it to work. And as a follow-up of the previous video, in this video I'll show you how to make those changes to your own sketch. Let's get started right away. So this is the previous sketch. This is the snippet that you can find on my GitLab. When you're watching this video, that snippet has already been updated. But it's the snippet that I think most of you saw when the first video about MQTTS was released. So that's the baseline of this video. So you can make your adjustments based on that snippet. So first of all, we are going to include time.h. This is necessary because the bare SSL requires a time. Then we're going to change Wi-Fi client secure into bare SSL. Wi-Fi client secure. Now that's done. And while we're here, we can just remove the bottom two lines because they don't apply. The upload settings are still the same. So this is zero. this is still the same. This is still the same. This is still the same. But this is where it gets different. And I'm hoping that you didn't change those names, because you can just replace this with this piece of code. This will read the new certificates, because you need to change the type of certificates that you've got on your internal file system. And we'll put them into the correct objects for usage. Now there's one more change we need to make, or actually two. In here you can see that the certificates are opened. In the previous video, we converted the human readable PAM certificates to DARE certificates. That's binary. And since bare SSL is capable of parsing the human readable version, and we'll be using that, you need to change DARE to CRT and DARE key to key. Save it. Then this is basically done. What this does is it loads all the new certificates, then it sets the clock, and then it works as it's supposed to work. So no more changes in the sketch side. So there's one change, two more changes. You can see the previous certificates, that are those two, the DARE and DARE key. Now you can just remove them, and you need to copy your .crt and your .key files from your server that you've generated with ECRSA. You don't need to generate new certificates. You don't need to do that, because the certificates are valid. They are perfectly fine. Just copy the human readable versions of them over, and it should work. Now open your certificate, your .crt. Now it opens on another window, and there is a possibility that a lot of text and details may be above this begin certificate. You need to remove that. The begin certificate is needs to be the first line of the .crt file, otherwise it doesn't work. So save it. Also check your .key file, that should be human readable too. Then connect your device, press ESP sketch data upload, wait for it to complete, and then hit upload. And if all is good, it should work. It should do, well, nothing except when you trigger it, of course. Open the serial monitor just for just in case, and if you don't see anything strange, then it's all good, and it's fine. Now, before I upload this new snippet to GitLab, I will add a nice feature, because sometimes I've had the experience that the ESPs tend to crash, and with that feature, you're able to recognize a frozen ESP. Because the internal LED will fade in and out continuously, and if it doesn't fade, it's frozen. So I'll add those things to the code, then I'll upload it to GitLab. Yeah, that's basically it. The only thing you need to keep in mind is that when you upload the new code before you've uploaded the certificates, the whole thing won't work, and when you do it vice versa, the whole thing won't work either. So I really recommend that you take your ESPs and sonoffs and reconnect them via serial to your computer, and then upload the certificates and the code, or vice versa. It doesn't really matter. But if you do it via OTA, yeah, one of the two is going to fail. I haven't had any success with updating the internal file system over the air. So I really recommend to just plug it into your computer and upload it via serial. That's the best way. Oh, by the way, you can set the upload speed to 256.000, because it makes life a little bit faster. So yeah, that was it for this video. A quick and easy tutorial. Took me a while to convert the sketch, because the error that Beer SSL gave me wasn't very helpful, let's call it that way. And my mosquito broker just said, yeah, the client connected, but it didn't supply a certificate, so client disconnected, bye. And I was not sure why the thing was disconnecting. Turns out it was a missing end of file marker. So as you can see, I've added them there, there, and there, and now it's working. It's working perfectly. I've updated, I think, 80% of all my Node MCUs and Sonoffs, and yeah, it's still working. So that was it for this video. Thanks for watching, and goodbye, and see you in the next one. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like. Make sure to leave a comment down below. You can also share this video with your friends if you think they will like it too. See you next time.